Hi, boys and girls. Today we're going to continue talking about adding two-digit numbers together. Remember when we talk about this, that when we talk about a digit, that this has one, two digits. And I'm also thinking about the place that those digits are in. I know that I have the tens place and I have the ones place. So now I want to talk about adding these numbers together. So when I look at the numbers, if I have the problem 13 plus 14, so first I'm going to say I have a 1 in the tens place. If I have 1 10, I have 10. And then I have a 3 in the ones place. 3 ones is equal to 3. Then I'm going to do the same thing for 14. I have a 1 in the tens place, 1 group of 10 is equal to 10. And I have a 4 in the ones place, and 4 ones would be equal to 4. So now I want to add these together. So that if I'm going to put them here, I'm going to say 10 plus 3, because that makes 13, and 10 plus 4. Equals 14. I'm going to draw my line underneath, and then I'm going to put a plus sign here on the side. Now, when I add them, I'm going to add the tens first. So 10 plus 10 more would be what? 20 plus 3 plus 4, which is equal to 7. So now I know if I have 20 plus 7, because remember that 7, I'm just going to put it in that zero spot, okay? So I have 20 plus 7. My answer is 27. So if I come up here, I know that 13 plus 14 is equal to 27, okay? So you're going to break apart the number, add together the tens, add together the ones, and then put the number together. All right, so let's do a couple more. So let's say I have, and I want to make sure I have enough space to do several here. So if I say I have 14 plus, let's do the number 72. 72. So what are we going to do? I'm going to put an equal sign at the end. So first I'm going to break apart 14. So if I have a 1, in the tens place, so 1 group of 10, that's equal to 10. I have a 4 in the ones place, so 4 ones would equal 4. Then I'm going to break apart the 72. The 7 is in tens place, so if I have 7 groups of 10, I have 70. And 2 ones equal 2. So now I'm going to add those two numbers together. So I'm going to say I have 10 plus 4. And then underneath of it, I'm going to put my plus, 70 plus 2. Draw my line underneath. So now I'm going to do the tens first. Remember, the tens first. And I'm going to say 10 plus 70. So I'm going to say 1 plus 7 is 8, and I'm going to bring my 0 down, plus 4 plus 2, 4, 5, 6. So now, if I have 80 plus 6, what do I have? 86. So I know 14 plus 72 equals 86. Okay, so I'm adding the tens and then adding the ones and then putting it together, adding the tens and adding the ones. So let's do, I'm going to try to do another one down here at the bottom if we can squeeze it in. Let's do 44 plus 13, 44 plus 13. So first, I'm breaking apart that 44. So when I look, I've got a 4 in the tens place. How much do I have if I have 4 groups of 10? 40. Then I have A four also in the ones place. Four ones, how much do I have? Four. Now I'm going to break apart the 13. And I have one group of 10. So how much is that? It's one, isn't it? It's 10. I'm going to circle my four, don't I? And I have a three in the ones place. How much do I have? Three. So now I'm going to do what? I'm going to add the tens first. So I have, and I'm going to come over here, 40 plus 4 plus 10 plus 3, 10 plus 3. That's going to mess it up, isn't it? I'll have to move this, do it like that for now. All right, so I'm going to draw my line underneath, and I'm going to add the tens first. 40 plus 10 more is what? 50. Plus 4 plus 3 is what? 7. 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I have 50 plus 7, how much do I have? Yeah, 57. So then that means 44 plus 13 is equal to 57. I'm just going to put it above there. Okay. So when we have these two-digit numbers, you can't be afraid of them, but like I said yesterday, you got to know your facts, because if you mess it, you might know how to do it, but if you don't add it correctly, then your problem's wrong, okay? So you got to take your time, watch your adding, make sure you're adding carefully to get the right answer, okay? Let's try doing just one more. I'll just try to fit it someplace on here. Let's go to the very top. 37 plus 21. 37 plus 21 equals what? Well, 37. Break it apart. A 3 in the tens place, I have 30. Plus a 7 in the ones place, it is 7. Now let's do 21. If I have a 2 in the tens place, what is it? Say it out loud. Yeah. It's going to be 20. And I have a 1 in the ones place. How much is it? Yep, 1. So now let's add it together. We have 30 plus 7 and 20 plus 1. Draw my line underneath. Put my plus sign out to the side so I know what I'm doing. 30 plus 20. 3 plus 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I'm going to bring that 0 right down, plus 7, 8. So what's my answer then? Remember, taking that 8, putting it right on top of that 0, and what's my answer? 58. So if this is 58, that means 37 plus 21 is also 58. 58, all right? So this is just another strategy that you can use to solve these problems. Again, I'm going to say, you got to know your facts. Keep practicing. I know we've not assigned extra math, but that's a good way to get faster at knowing your math facts, and it's a good way for you to practice. So if you've not been doing that, I would suggest you do to get better at your math facts and getting it so that you can know them just like that, because you got to get to where you do know them pretty fast so that you are better about adding together these numbers. All right, we'll continue working on this tomorrow.